If you're looking for prospects, LinkedIn is a great option, especially when you combine it with a browser extension that's called Wiza. It's gonna help you grab the contact information from these profiles. Now, if you're a LinkedIn powered user that uses sales navigation, well, it also integrates with that and you're gonna be able to export a bunch of contacts with this system. So let me show you how in this video right now. Getting started with Wiza is actually super easy. All you have to do is sign up for Wiza, grab the browser extension, jump into LinkedIn or LinkedIn Sales Navigator, and start pulling in that contact information so you can start sending out your sales pitch. That's how easy. Now, if you want to check it out, link will be provided in the description. Now, like I said, install the browser extension, which is obviously nothing hard to do, and then jump into LinkedIn. Once you're on LinkedIn, we're going to be able to take full potential of Wiza. There's a little icon here, and there's the browser extension installed over here. So I know that everything is good. Now, let's start off by pulling some contact information from some of these contacts. So I'm just going to scroll randomly here, and I'm going to grab here, Jonathan. So let's click on Jonathan. Here we go. And we have a Wiza icon here on the bottom and the button. I'm going to click on it over here. Now, here we go. It says I want to find the email address, and I have the option to grab the phone if I want to. So let's just say that I don't do telemarketing. Maybe I don't want to grab the phone. But in this case, I'll try to find it. So let's go ahead and reveal the contact information, and Wiza is going to do its magic. Be aware that if it doesn't pull the contact information, it won't deduct any credits, okay? So let's wait for Wiza to do its magic. Oh, here we go, it's done. So in this case, it found the email, but no phone number. Let's go ahead and try another one. Luis here, let's reveal his contact information and let's see if it does its magic. Boom, okay, so we got the email and the phone number. So we grab this information. Now that we have this, I can go ahead and save it to a list. Now I have two lists here and I'm going to send it out to my test for video. You can go ahead and create a list right from here if you want. So I'm gonna do it here. Here we go, it's been saved to it. There's also information for the company like the name, the headcount, founded, location, and the about. And on the bottom, we can see our email credits and phone credits. Now, inside of this widget, there's also the contact information for the list where you pull in the information. So in this case, I have someone in this contact list, and there's also the history for the information, all right? So now that we have this, I can go ahead and start sending this out and push it to my email marketing system to start sending out, obviously, my sales pitch. Now I can go ahead and start surfing around on LinkedIn and grab the contact information one by one, which is fine. But what if you can do this in bulk mode? Well, if you're taking advantage of LinkedIn and you got Sales Navigator, you can bulk export a bunch of contacts. And let me show you how. So I'm gonna use the lead filter from LinkedIn Sales Navigator. Go ahead and close this. And for example, you can filter out contacts by obviously using the filters. So in this case, we can grab contacts. I'm gonna select medium company. So I want 51 to 200 and 201 to 500. So medium sized company. And then we have more filters available here for in this case, buyer intent. So we're gonna use marketing for this and video marketing software. So let's say that I have a video recorder software that I wanna sell to. So I wanna get people who are interested in that. There's a spotlight information, posted content, there's more filter in here by industry. Let's select something by industry. Let's go in software development. Okay, that's good. So again, you can go through this and obviously fine tune it to grab the right audience for your sales pitch. Okay. So here on the right, there's a button for that the Wiza gives us. It's export leads with Wiza. So we're gonna click on that. It's gonna open up this page. Now we have three options. One is I wanna grab the information, but I don't need email. That means I just want the full name, title, company, LinkedIn URL, or location. And this would be for reasons that you just wanna save them and later contact them or automate it for something else. The next one is emails only. So it won't grab the phone. And if you need email and phone, use this one. So in this case, I wanna make only email. I wanna do something quick. I'm gonna name this test for video 2. And then the folder, I'm gonna send it to my test folder and the number of contacts that I want to pull. So in this case, I just wanna pull 5 for demo purposes. And then we have the accepted email types. So we have the work emails, which are custom domain. That means that are not Gmail, Hotmail, etc. There's the personal ones where we do get the Hotmails, the Gmails, etc., and the generic just for all type of emails. So in this case, I'll leave 3 of them on. Let's go ahead and click next. If everything is good, you like how it is, go ahead and continue. If not, go back and fine tune it. But in this case, I'll start the scan now. So it's gonna pull this information for me, and it's gonna let me know if it's a valid, risky, or all the emails. So in this case, I'm not gonna wait for that right now. We already have a list that I've pulled for 5 contacts, and you can see that the 5 contacts were valid on this export. There, I can also get risky contacts. That means that if I send out an email, it might bounce. I don't recommend sending out emails to these emails because you're gonna affect your email reputation, but it's up to you if you wanna do so, okay? And then you can grab all the emails. So if there's valid and riskies, you can grab all by clicking on the all. And we can send out a push to my Zapier because I'm connected. So in this case, I can send valid and risky, valid only, or all contacts. So just like that, I can send this Zapier and start an automation. Okay, so now it just finished for the test we just made, and we got 5 valid emails also. So it's a great email list and it's super easy to use. Now, I want to show you the main dashboard of how to use Wiza. So first of all, we're in the list section and we're gonna go into the folder and we're gonna be able to view all the folders that we've created. So example, this one, that's the test, sales nav, my list, and we can create a new folder right here and continue with this information. Now I can go ahead and jump into contacts. So you're gonna be able to view all the contacts that you've pulled information from. That means that if you pull contacts individually in LinkedIn or all the contacts from your LinkedIn Sales Navigator, we're gonna be able to view them here. We can take advantage of the filters and we can export via CSV if you wanna pull this into our email marketing system manually. So that's possible. There's also the integrations if you wanna automate the process. You can connect to Salesforce, Outreach, HubSpot, Pipedrive, Zapier, Zoho. For me, basically, I would connect to Zapier because with Zapier, you can connect with practically any CRM, any email marketing system, or anything that you want to connect to. So Zapier would be the way to go. It's super easy to set up. All you have to do is click on this. It'll provide you an API key, and you'll jump into Zapier for the connection. So once you connect, which is over here, you're gonna be able to start a flow with Zapier. So in Zapier, you're gonna connect with the trigger. Trigger is the thing that has to happen first in order to start. So the trigger is going to be a contact synced. So that means this is going to trigger the flow. And what do I wanna do with this? Well, I wanna send out an email contact information to my Sendinblue account, which is my email marketing system. With that system, I can do some automation to start sending out emails however I want. I can do an automation or just send an email right away. So that's one of the ways you can do it. Or something really simple, connect it to my Gmail and start sending out the emails. So for example, with the two, that means who am I gonna send this out to? Well, from the Wiza email, you set that up there. From, obviously we can put our email. So it's gonna be me. In this case, I'll select my email. From name, it could be, for example, SaaS Master. Keep it simple. Reply to, well, obviously me, same email. The subject, you can add whatever you want and you can actually use the information from the variables that you grab from the Wiza contact information and the body to start sending out your sales pitch. Once you have that automation set up and good to go, every single time that you push a Wiza contact into Zapier, it's gonna start the flow and start sending out your sales pitch automatically. That's pretty cool, right? That's a way that you can automate. Now, another thing that Wiza has is team members. So if you have a large team, team members is a great way to take advantage of Wiza so you can start using all the information. Now, it's pretty cool that you have the option to pull emails and phone credits. So if you just want to send out emails, well, just grab email credits. But if you have a telemarketing company, well, you want to take advantage of phone credits. But it's a super easy way and easy system to start grabbing contact information and start sending out sales pitch to new prospects. So there you go, that is Wiza. If you wanna start out, like I said, link will be provided in the description. Get started right away, start a test, and if you like it, well, jump into a plan. That's a wrap for Wiza.